Well, okay, that's one. Anyway, good evening and welcome to a one day late stream. So yesterday I was supposed to stream, but I had planned this silly little tattoo. Which I was supposed to have a week beforehand, but due to reasons, they had to reschedule for a week later, so for yesterday. And the timing was pretty bad. If I wanted to stream, I wouldn't make it, so I figured, let's put it on today. Let's see how the audience is doing on a Saturday instead of a Friday. I am probably going to paint a bit weird, as I got the tattoo on my finger. Got a little mustache. but yeah, I'm right-handed, so I will probably just cut the finger off of the glove, because I cannot cover it just yet. So let me struggle for a bit more and get back to you. So I'll just try to paint with not that one, just hold it like this. So yeah, this is the new project. I think this is pretty cool. This piece is called A Lunch with a Dragon. She's eating some noodles, same as my lunch today. And she's also holding some chopsticks, which have an extension. She's holding a little dumpling between the chopsticks, but I'm afraid I'm going to break them, so I'm just leaving them off until I've painted the rest, and then I will add them on to this piece. Apparently, I can only zoom in. It's quite a big piece, it's a bust. I had hoped to zoom out just a bit more, but apparently that's not an option. So the packaging, whoops, is absolutely amazing. It's in a food container-like box with chopsticks and all these ingredient stickers, like a boiled egg and some dumplings. And also the card that shows there are only 150 of these, and I've got number 29. First idea for when I start a new project, and originally I was thinking like paint it like one of my favorite noodle packages, which is the kimchi ramyun. I mean, it has red and a bit of green in the letters, also black, but it didn't really feel like, okay, that's it. So the second idea I got was to paint the dragon in a blue-green color, and then her hair orange. I like that contrast. I mean, it fits together, but it's very different from each other. But then I was Pinterested for a bit, and I came across this image of a water dragon that had a transition from blue to green to orange. I was like, I mean, I can start him here in a more blue tone, going up to green, and then on his wings and on his head doing some orange details. I think it will look pretty cool. And then for her hair to be red. The rest of the clothes I don't know yet. But it's always good to have a start at least. So the only thing I can actually see very clear in my mind now is the dragon. So I would like to start with him. And go for this blue-green-orange idea. And this paint job, I'm going back to my purple shadows and my yellow highlights. So I will have the purple. This is the blue I liked most. Going to a green. And then to this orange. With this yellow for the highlights. And of course, black and white. So it's gonna be quite colorful. As for her hair, going for this red, so the red and orange next to each other. I think that's going to be pretty awesome. But of course, it's always a surprise if it actually comes out the way I had in mind. I mean, you have this vision when you start, but there's no guarantee it will actually look like that. Sometimes I'm just doing something and hopes it would look right. So yeah, we'll see. Also, I was a bit too eager to put them together, so I have just freshly primed them and then put them together to take a picture. So I damaged it a bit, but it's where they connect anyway, so you won't see it in the end result. Just going to ignore that. You won't see a thing. See it now, but not when it's done. Anyway, let me get some colors onto the palette, and then proceed with this paint job. And apparently my purple is clogged. What is going on? Got it. So that's purple. Gonna need a yellow. I am going to try to keep in mind what they told me at the previous competition, like, don't make everything the same amount of right. Not sure how to call that in English, but to have a bit more focus on the main parts and darken the rest, so to really draw in that attention. So I'm gonna do my best, try to keep reminding me of the fact I'm going too bright and too vibrant. More shadows. I mean, I like vibrance, but if it's something they really want to see in these competitions, I can at least try. I mean, it's never a bad thing to try new things. So let's see. I think I want to go blue first, then bump it up to a green on the top of him. Probably also around the edges of his arms and on his cheeks, and then go from his cheeks up to a more orange. I think that's a decent plan. But am I going with just the blue and green first, or am I going to add the purple and black immediately? It's difficult. Trying to envision what to do here. Just stare at it until it tells me what to do. Is always the most difficult, and then once I get going I will find my directions, but start, man. You know what, I'm going to go for the color straight from the bottle and then add everything to that. So at least I have a start. And the start will probably tell me what step number two will be. Go green first, go blue first. overthinking. Yes, I am. Let's go for blue. Very vibrant. Sure how far I want that blue to go up, so I'm just going to paint it like halfway in. trying to get the nice coverage everywhere. Let me quickly check what the cat's up to. And I think that if I will add the greens to this, except for his face, and I'm not touching the wings just yet, because there I want to have some orange. I think I can envision how this will turn out. At least partially. I mean, I never know how far I will take some details. But, yeah. I do like this blue. It's a very nice color. It's called the Canterbury Blue. And it reminds me of a different color. I want to say it reminds me of Prussian blue from Greens of Worlds. There is some difference. It's a bit darker. But I've always liked this color. Come on, dragon, drive faster. It's bloody hot in this room and he's taking its time to dry. Right, I wanted to show you the little mood board I created with Pinterest vines. Okay. Something like that. Anyway, the red hair from the lady. Then I found that dragon. With the blue, green, and the orange. I think that's pretty cool. And then this lovely Japanese pattern for her skirt or her top, I think. I'm not sure. And then this image, I think, is really cool. It's a bit difficult to show with a screen being filmed. But to me it looks like there is purple in the shadows and the light is yellow, so it's exactly the thing that I like to do. So yeah, with that in mind, this project is kicking off in a good way. Are you dry enough? I'd say yes. Let's add some greens to it. Lovely green. Trying to get in all the nooks and crannies here. But I want the orange. I think I'm going to extend the green just a bit more. I mean, having a bit overlap is always good to make transitions. I've used this big brush as much as I'm doing now. Always making everything more difficult by using two small brushes. The blue to green transition. I mean, it's very rough still, but I think the colors work very, very nice together. Wary. I'm not wary. As well. Starry Orange. It's a nice color. This is probably going to look a bit weird without the transition. I will get there. Let's see how it looks with some orange on there. Well, hello there. Good evening. I hope this Saturday stream suits you well. For me. I mean, yesterday it just wasn't an option, but I didn't want to cancel the stream completely. And I was looking forward to this as well. Nice. So it was a good thing for you that yesterday wasn't an option. Cow with wings. Maybe. I mean, if it's a dragon who wants to have a little bite of the ramen, then it's probably not a flesh-eating one. So, cow with wings, sure. Milk bomber. How far do I want these patterns to go? Maybe a bit asymmetrical would be cool? Like, why would it have to be completely the same on both sides? So. like that. Something like that. I mean, that looks natural, right? I mean, besides of the colors and the fact it's dragon, but pattern wise. Never met a dragon in person. Well, that will be difficult then. Yeah, please do let me know if it's natural for a dragon to look like this. Should I leave it as a mask? Like, just like those cows, for example, the black, white, black, or with brown? No spots, just markings, as if they are parted by three. So, should this dragon maybe just have the face mask, or should I add it to the rest of his neck as well? I mean, I don't even think about that, but like the horses, indeed. I'm going to do that. Just leave it on the face. Maybe a bit on the ear. You can can still give me tips and advice. I always appreciate that. Hello, hello, good evening. Welcome to a new project. A very, very colorful dragon. Going for something very colorful yet again. Best painted miniatures are not painted by yourself. Are they all done by the same artists? Or do you have a collection of different ones? Difficult. I think that would be cool. You know what he reminds me of? Those, what do you even call them? The bird dino type creatures they use in the movie Avatar? Like the blue Avatar, not the elements. He reminds me a bit of that. That's not a bad thing. This is cool. Do you have something that is your favorite if it comes to types of miniatures? I mean, do you like warriors? Do you like more natural forms like animals or dragons? Maybe something more futuristic like robots? Better transition between the green and the blue. I just mixed those two colors and now paint them 50% over the green and 50% over the blue. Thank you. lava dragon. Oh, that's pretty cool. Does it also have some, like, of that black crusty texture in there? Or is it mostly fire? This mini is called a lunch with a dragon. A bit difficult to paint. Ah, that's cool. I always like when they add a bit of that lava crust to, well, if it's a dragon, to the dragon scales. To just the green. missed a spot there, apparently. I'm just going back and forth between these colors until the transition is just how I want it, as smooth as possible. I mean, the transition between the blue and green doing very well, and the orange, I don't want a very perfect looking transition. I want it to be a pattern, so I will have to look for a middle path, like how much do I want it to transition into a different color and how much do I want it to be its own colored piece. Going back in with the blue. That is totally fine. What are you painting? Orcs are always fun to paint. I mean, I enjoy to paint color green. And yeah, most orcs are. The paint's from, what's that guy's name again? Duncan? I'm absolutely terrible with names, so I'm sorry about that. The transition is working out very, very nice. Oh yeah, that's the name. I swear, one day I will forget my own name. Brush behind my ear. I am not sure yet about the wings. You won't see that much of them anyway. So I will have to check. He looks like a kind dragon. Bit rude, perhaps. But I am doing this to check where I need to start adding highlights. I really want to focus it on this part right here, so the rest will be a bit darker. So the tail won't get that much highlight, but his arm, for instance, will, because it's in this circle. She will get red hair, like this red, which I think will look very pretty next to the orange of his mask pattern. So highlights for the green. The doubts again. From his elbow. Yet another very interesting project for me, because I have this idea in mind, but I have no idea how I'm going to get there. So I'm probably going to do things like two, three, or four times over what I've done before. Probably going to look very stupid, weird, and unnecessary, but so I'm just trying to ignore this for a bit. It would have been easier to first paint the green skin completely and then add the pattern to that, because now I have to work around it. While I'm painting him, I'm trying to get rid of the anxiety to mess him up. Like, what's there to mess up? I just started. But that voice in your head's always rattling, like, stop, no. I'm just trying to paint and find that sweet spot where I'm like, okay, this is going in the right direction, just keep your eyes on the finish. But in the meantime, it will probably be a lot of layers on layers, stuff I already painted. Maybe I should stick her on there just momentarily so I can see where to place the highlights. Starting to come to life. This will definitely become brighter. I only added a bit of yellow to the green so far, not any whites yet, because I really want to find where to place the highlights. Having a bit of a wrinkly skin, I'm using that to add some of the texture. I mean, he does not have to look completely smooth. There can be some brush strokes. It's just nice to have this skin type so I can add little scratches with the paint. Thank you. the side I want to keep very dark. So I will only add darker colors to this. I'm working on the highlights first. Cannot help this, but I really want just the tiniest amount here. Where before this project is done, it's one big heap of very vibrant colors. Is that a bad thing? No, but maybe try to listen to what the judges, the jury is saying. Judge. Am I going to be arrested if I'm doing this wrong? Okay, I'm going for one more highlight for the green. So this time I'm going to add yellow and white. Starting to look pretty cool. I can't wait to see that face pattern come to life. Of the magic dragon, that doesn't ring a bell to me. Could you maybe sing it? can take her off now. Gives me a nice indication up till where I have to paint the highlights. Would be a shame to paint highlights all over and then have her block like half of it. Wouldn't be the first thing that ever happens. Like, no, I've had that happen so many times. It's such a shame if you put in so much effort and then you don't even see it. So try to be smart this time. I hope it works out. Now I can reach this a bit better. how vibrant this is starting to look. I mean, it's not as clean as I want it to be. This side especially, I really like. And of course, the orange still looks very flat. I have not touched that besides placing the pattern. And I've pushed the green a bit too far so I can blend it in with each other. Thank you. to end the stream here for tonight. And apparently I was having a blast, because it's been 2.5 hours. That's a good start for the first session. Definitely happy with that. Cannot wait to start her skin and hair. I think it will look very cool with the red hair next to him. Tomorrow I will be back for the second stream, and I will probably start on his face pattern. I really want to work on those highlights first, blend them in a bit better, and see where that takes me. Just the slightest amount of highlights on his back. Probably will need to get some more there. But I have not placed any shadows yet. This is all just from the medium to highlights. And the shadows will be placed, especially on this side here. I want to keep the attention on this section right here. So yeah, I will take some pictures for Instagram. Hopefully you like it. And I will be back tomorrow. Same time, probably not as long as today, but we'll see what happens. So, good evening, good rest of the day, enjoy your weekend, and hopefully see you soon. Bye.